Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to use a substance painter to create the materials, to create the substance for Blender. As demo, very quick, I use the original cube here. So now I'm going to export this to here. This is the object mode. I click here, then File, Export, FBX on my desktop. This is the original Blender cube. Export the FBX here. So once you open it, actually this one don't have any texture yet, and it is just a cube mesh. So the next, I'm going to minimize the Blender. And this one, this is the Steam. And I already purchased the Substance Painter 2020 just to launch it. The Substance Painter. So once it starts, this one you can click close. Then your cube, the Blender cube, you can just to drag in and click OK. Then you wait for a while, it will appear here. If you hold the alternate key, you can rotate. Hold the alternate key by using the middle buttons, you can move the camera. So now how to use this? You can see now the material already selected. You have so many materials here. For example, if I choose the carbon fiber, drag in. Okay, so now it already adds the substance here. You can see some light reflection. Okay, so you see here the scale. You can change it. If you want to add some painting, you can just click here, create paint layer. Then you can choose, for example, I want to choose the gold, the pure gold. Then now I can paint on here. This is the gold paint. Aluminium. Okay, so you can see different reflection already. The size of the paint. The carbon fiber. Again, if I choose the carbon fiber, can create a totally new painting here. This one. The size. If I choose the wood, paint it here, then it become wood. If you want to delete it, you can delete from here. Actually, every time you create something, it is a new layer. Delete. Okay, Control-Z. Control-Z is to undo. Here I can create a new layer again. New layer. Let's say if I want this, that's this. So now I also can choose some brush, a different brush. Choose material again. Titanium, plastic, brush size. Okay, this is the height, material, normal, height, metallic, base color. Then to combine them all together, it is the material. As you can see, different type of material, they have different characteristics. The carbon fiber, let's say the scale, I make it really big. Or small. Alright, you always remember here, you have the bumps, all this. How to export it out? So now, I'm going to show you, after you done your job, how to export it. Export it here. File, export texture. Then, you click here. This is the folder. I copy the folder destination. Control C to copy. After that, I open the file explorer, paste here, click here, Control V to paste, enter. Now this folder already open. Here, once I click export, you export in this folder. Export. See, everything exported here. So now what can I do? How to make it, how to import into Blender. Now you see I open the Blender. How to change the texture here? Go to the UV editing. Then click here. The first one is the base color. Click the base color. Change to image texture. After that, which one is the base color? This one. So, open. Copy this location, Control C, paste here, enter the base color. Okay, so now I click here. Now I can see the base color, but without the bump. So the next, what are you going to change it? The metallic. Do you have the metallic map? Yes, I have one. So click metallic, click here, scroll up, image texture, open, browse, okay. Copy this location, Control C, paste here, Control V, enter, the metallic. All right. So now we added the metallic. Then what is the next? Check here. The normal map and the roughness. The roughness is here. So click here. Scroll up. Image texture. Then the roughness. Open. Here, Control V, enter. The roughness is here. Alright. So now already add the roughness. And the most important one is the normal map. So these two look similar. You can choose either one, the OpenGL one or the normal. So where is the normal? Normal is at here. Click. Then select normal map. After that, it will appear this. Click here. Choose image texture. After that, open. Where to open? Still here. This location. Control C. Click here. Control V. Enter. The normal map, I choose this. So now, you can see it is exactly, it already have the normal map. See? If you back to the Substance Painter, you can see exactly. all this already there. How about here? Okay, everything are here already. The normal. The normal strength, you can adjust it. The reflection also complete. So another software that I recommend is iClone. It have a better rendering. We can just to compare them. What are the differences? So everything already complete. The normal map, roughness, metallic, and diffuse. The base color. All this already import into the texture UV. Back to the layout. Click here. You can see very clear. So if I use the iClone, it also should be the same. This is the cube just now. Drag in. All the 3D software are similar, but different rendering effect. Alright, this one. What should I do? I click here. The materials are zero, totally none. So I just need to drag in the base color, this one. The bump, the normal map. After that, what else? Metallic, drag in. Roughness, drag in. The height, the displacement, drag in. Okay. So now you can see different software, different rendering effect. For here, iClone have a better rendering. Here I can remember the carbon fiber, the gold, and the aluminium just now. Click here, material. Then you can show everything. Then how about here? The bump, everything okay. The blender also okay. Somewhere here, and the materials. Alright, that is how we use the Substance Painter to create the substance and materials for our 3D, for our blender. And even you can export this as FBX again, then you can use it in any 3D software. Alright, that's all for today about the Substance Painter, the Blender, and extra the iClone. Thank you for watching. If you love my video tutorial, you can subscribe my YouTube channels and turn on the mini bell so that when next time I publish a new video, you will receive the notification immediately. See you in my next video.